Thomas here, and welcome back to another video. So today I'm back here for another speed build, and today we're going to go ahead and create this home called, I think I'm going to mispronounce it, it's either Azor or Azori, I'm not really 100% sure on that, and I'll explain what that name means in a second, so that and then laying on the end of it, as you can see from the title. And yeah, so if you'd like to go ahead and download this for yourself, it is up in the gallery now. My origin ID is real ThomasTV1. So this home has 4 bedrooms, 3 bathrooms, and it came in at just over 207,000 simoleons, and it is kind of like a family home. I didn't really do kids' rooms for it, it's kind of got modern and traditional aspects to it, and you'll see what I mean by that once we actually get onto the inside. So yeah, like I was saying about the name of the home, now Azor or Azori, I don't know how you pronounce it, that name, well basically, I went into this build without really having a name for it or like a idea of what I was going to do. I was kind of just in the mood to build, but I was kind of just having a bit of builder's block, and I just couldn't really think what to do, because I've been building so much recently that it's kind of just getting a lot kind of repetitive if I just want to kind of go ahead and build something that isn't really have a specific theme to it. But Cats and Dogs is coming out pretty soon. Maybe by the time you see this, it's already out. I'm not really 100% sure. I'm actually recording this on the 29th of October. It's definitely going up into November. I'm not too sure when though. So yeah, so when Cats and Dogs come out, I'll have loads of ideas again, because I already have a huge big list of ideas for that. But yeah, so I wasn't really too sure what I was going to do, and I just couldn't really build. I don't know what was wrong with me. I had been building something pretty big earlier in that day, so I was probably a little bit tired, but I was still in the mood to build. So I don't know, I spent like 15 minutes trying to do something and it just didn't work out, so I kind of had a little bit of break, had a rethink of things, and came back to do this. And I'm still pretty, I mean, I could have done better in some areas, but I think that's the thing with every single build, everybody can do better, I think. But you know, yeah, I'm still pretty happy how it turned out. So yeah, like I said, it is up in the gallery. My origin ID is real ThomasTV1. So the name Azor, what that comes from is that the siding that I used on this home is actually blue, and I was kind of thinking maybe if I could come up with a name including the, like, that's something to do with the blue, because blue is kind of like a main colour scheme, at least on the outside it is. So I was thinking, what could I do? Because I can't really call it a blue house, because that just doesn't sound very good. So I was kind of just looking up other names that mean blue, and this name came up, Azor. Like I said, I don't know how to pronounce it. And basically what it means, I'm sorry, I'm taking a break here. Hopefully I come back in a second, otherwise I'm going to have to stop the recording to take the spit out, and then, yeah, anyway, So, it means kind of like a blue sky, like a clear blue sky, so I thought that's kind of a nice name, so I went ahead and chose for this one, since, you know, I did want to have something to do with blue in the home, and that's the name I came up with. So it's a little bit more original than what I normally do, so I'm kind of happy about that. Anyway, so we're just working on kind of like the outside things here. Getting the basic shape of the home. As you can see in the back garden there, I did like a curved porch area, which is something I don't think I've ever done that before. I know it's like an object in game, like a preset thing to place down, because you can't actually do curves like that. But I just kind of thought I would do something a little bit different, and I did that, and I thought it looked pretty nice. So what I was going to say about it, so yeah, like I said earlier, it's kind of got a traditional and a modern theme to it. Mostly on the outside, it's all mostly traditional, but on the inside, a few of the bedrooms are a little bit more modern. I guess you could think of it as that they've been renovated or something like that. So like I was saying earlier about it not having any kids' rooms, my kind of thinking behind that is in a lot of these homes, a lot of the other areas of the home may be a little bit more, not really upper scale, but just not that, I don't know, just a little bit more formal in a way, not so, I don't really know how to explain it, to be honest. So I feel like sometimes if I'm going to go ahead and put a kids' room in, it doesn't really fit that well to the rest of the theme of the home. But in this room, it would have fit all right, I think, but I was just kind of wanting to go for more of a modern bedroom styles. And I think they did look pretty good. I did use actually quite a lot of items from City Living in this build, which is what I always do, to be honest. It kind of fits a lot of different themed builds I do. But for this one, I kind of use it quite a lot. So also another thing is the other night I was kind of just getting really bored and I was kind of just sitting on my laptop. I have a MacBook, but which I use sometimes when I'm not on my PC. And I was kind of just sitting downstairs and I was kind of thinking, I never really play on my MacBook, The Sims. I do have all the, like, the game installed and stuff on my MacBook, but I never play it on there. So I kind of just in the mood to try just doing some things, and I have no custom content or anything installed on that one. So I kind of just did a few custom content, free builds and Creator Sims. Not really builds, just room builds. I did two Creator Sims, and I also did two room builds. I did this vintage glamour room and also another one just called Simple Bedroom. And basically, in both of those rooms, they don't have any move objects on, and I didn't move them off the grid either. I wanted to make something kind of very EA-esque, I guess you could say, and I was kind of thinking that maybe it'll get favourited by Maxis, because it, you know, fills all those boxes, because I believe that, well, actually, I always thought that to get featured by Maxis on the gallery, you would have to not use any CC, of course, but also to not use move objects and not move the things off the grid by pressing alt and then moving the thing, just keeping it where it places down, so where it places down, if that makes sense. So I did that with those builds. Of course, it didn't get featured because I wasn't really expecting it to. But I was kind of just thinking I'd do something like that because I never really do builds like that ever, really. But the other day, I was kind of looking on the site because, you know, on that the right-hand side where, like, your notifications are on the gallery and it tells you Max's favourite this lot, blah, blah, blah. I was looking and somebody actually built this kind of Halloween sort of, I think it was like a park or something, and they had lots of scaled up items and everything, and it looked like move objects is on. So I was thinking, oh, well, Max's might actually feature things that don't have, you know, that have move objects on and things. So you never know. I'll see how things go. I'm not really bothered about if it gets featured or not. It would be nice one day to maybe have a lot featured or something. Let me know if you've ever had a lot featured and if you had move objects on or anything. That'd be really interesting to know. Anyway, so I had a little disaster the other day. Oh my God, it was pretty scary. If you follow me on Twitter, you'll probably know what I'm talking about here. But what happened was I was, like, finished for the night on my computer and stuff, and I turned all my lights off in the room because I was going downstairs, and, you know, there's no point leaving my lights on up here. So I turned all the lights off. I was going to go and get my my glass of water that was on my desk, and I kind of knew where it was, so I went ahead and I was in the dark at this point because I turned the lights off because I was just about to go downstairs, and then I think I did, but I missed it, and I just heard it, like, fall, and oh my God, my heart just stopped. And then I looked, and the water, after I turned the light on, I looked at the water glass, and it was falling over, and all the water went down the back of my desk, and it was all over my desk, on my speakers, it went down and trickled down into, like, that doesn't sound right, but you know what I mean, onto my PC tower. It was everywhere, and I just totally froze. I was, like, having a panic attack. I just didn't know what to do, because, like, I just absolutely panicked. Anyway, never mind, it got all sorted and everything. No actual damage done at all, really, which I was so, so surprised about, because it went down the back of my thing, and I have extension cables, you know, down there. You know those extension things where it's like the thing that you plug into the wall and then it comes off and it has like a little brick thing of four different slots. Well, those are kind of exposed because I didn't have them all full up with plugs in. So I was thinking, oh my God, they're going to go in there, it's going to explode. I tried to turn the computer off as soon as I could, so I put my hand at the back of my PC, you know where the power thingy is, oh my God, I can't think what it is, the power supply, and they have like a button at the back of your PC. I mean, maybe different for some PCs, but I went ahead and tried to flick the switch there, but I couldn't reach it, and I was feeling down there, and it was, I could feel the water going down. I was like, oh God. So I was just absolutely panicked. That was around 7 p.m, so I didn't turn my PC or anything. I tried to clean up as much water as I could, and then 9 o'clock the next morning, I turned everything on, it was fine. So I was very, very lucky there, because if that would have, you know, ruined my computer, then what am I going to do for builds? I'd be absolutely stuck, and I wouldn't be able to get videos up. Luckily, I did have a few videos pre-recorded at that point when that happened, so I would have been okay for a few days, but yeah, a little bit scary. I mean, I could have recorded stuff on my Mac, but it's not, like, because it's on my MacBook, the resolution isn't 1080p, like, it's not 1920 by 1080, the game resolution, so it wouldn't record right, and it wouldn't look right when I upload it. So, and I don't know why, if that's just my MacBook or not, I don't know, probably if I change around the settings or something, it'll work. But yeah, that was really scary. And Mark is a little bit slower in terms of the actual game, so yeah, I was really worried about that. And I was especially worried about if it would have gotten to the graphics card, because I don't know if you remember, but back talk too fast then and just blurted out a random word there. So back in December last year, I actually went ahead and bought a GTX 980 graphics card from Exurban SimsX, her old one. And I went ahead and bought that, and it was, you know, it was a little bit pricey, so I was really, really worried about that, because that's kind of the most expensive thing in terms of the components inside my PC, so I was really, really worried about that. But I was kind of thinking, the PC, like, the water is going to go down and then inject itself into the PC. It's just going to run past it, so that's probably why there was no damage done, but it was still really scary. Anyway, well, I was actually hoping to maybe get a new PC soon, because apart from the graphics card, all the other components in terms of the PC are getting kind of outdated. I still have Windows 7, and I feel like I'm the only one who still has Windows 7. But at the same time, Windows 7 still works really, really well, in my opinion. And I don't want to have to upgrade to Windows 10, because I feel like it might start to lag my PC, because it might not support it as well. So I'm just going to leave that alone, because Windows 7, it doesn't give me any problems. So what's the point of, you know, changing it if it's fine? So yeah, I was really hoping to maybe get a new PC for Christmas or something, but I'm doing my driving lessons now, so I'm thinking maybe a car. But at the same time, I don't really go that many places other than school into the shops and stuff, so what am I gonna really need a car for as much as I would need a PC? I mean, my PC at the minute is fine, it's not broken or anything. I'm just thinking about maybe upgrading. So what do I rather want? Do I want a nice new PC or a car? So I don't know, I'd probably a car seems to make more sense, but you know, I'll just think things through a little bit. And I couldn't afford a car at the minute anyway. I'll probably have to save up a little bit more. Anyway, so we're just working on the kitchen here. Now, I actually really, really like this kitchen area, because a lot of the times in these, well, it's not a small home. It's kind of like a medium-sized home, I would suppose. It's only 40 by 30 lot. But with these kitchens, I always tend to make them really big. And then I'm just putting appliances down everywhere, like on all the counters, and putting decorations everywhere to make it not look bare. But for this one, it actually turned out all right. It's kind of like a decent size. You know, I've got a few decorations down, but there's also a space to do a little bit of cooking there on one of those spare counters. So, you know, it isn't too big and too overpacked with stuff. And then also you can see the dining table right here as well. And I think they both look pretty nice in terms of how those are placed. And yes, so there's also something else I was going to mention. About streaming. So I wanted to ask you all about this. So I've been thinking about maybe doing some streaming, like stream games and stuff. Well, just The Sims probably for now, because I don't really play any other games. So I was thinking about maybe starting streaming now. I do have a Twitch if you want to go follow me there. My username there is ThomasTVYT. All one word, YT stand for YouTube. So I have a Twitch account there, and I have made like an offline screen stuff ready if I do go ahead and actually start streaming. I do watch other Twitch streams, and I do moderate for a few Twitch streams as well, but you know, I haven't done it myself yet. And I was thinking that maybe it's probably best for me, because it's probably not going to be something I'm going to like have an actual schedule for. It might just be when I get a bit of free time I'll be able to stream. So I'm thinking about maybe starting off on YouTube, because you know, that this is where all my audience is. So I was thinking that maybe if I go ahead and do my first stream on Twitch, I'm going to be kind of like having two separate audiences, if that makes sense. So I'm thinking about doing is maybe starting some YouTube streams to kind of build up my audience here and things, see if you like it or not, and then we'll move over to Twitch, because I feel like Twitch is a little bit better for streaming. But don't worry, I won't be stopping YouTube, because YouTube is my main thing that I love to do. I don't know what I think about streaming. A lot of the time, I don't really have a lot of time to watch streams, because, you know, you can't, like, it's not one of those things where you can kind of pause it if you have to go ahead and do something. You have to kind of be paying attention the whole time, if that makes sense. I mean, you probably don't, but that's kind of what I think about it. So, and then if, you know, people do replays of streams, but I always kind of find them not as interesting. Sorry to anybody who does those, but it's just like, I feel like that I'm kind of going to be watching back like 2 hours or something, and it's not really like an actual video where you kind of got your full focus on, if that makes sense. I don't really know what I'm talking about here. So I don't really know what to do. I'm kind of just thinking things through. And the other thing is that there's always like somebody home. Like at the minute I'm recording this, there's nobody home. And you can probably tell my voice, I'm a little bit more louder, I guess you could say, when nobody's home. But when there is, I'm a little bit more quiet in my voiceovers and stuff. I try to leave all my voiceovers until there is nobody home. Sometimes my sister's home, but out with my parents and my sister is the only person, and actually the only person I know in real life who knows about my channel. My parents don't make videos, but they don't know what my actual channel is. So, and I wouldn't want it to, it would be too embarrassing, because what they do is, they'll like play it loud on the speakers and stuff, and it'll be really embarrassing, so that's why I'm not wanting to tell them about it. They know I make videos, and you know, they know I make money from it and things, because I've seen that sort of stuff, but not much money, but you know. I'm kind of thinking that I wouldn't really want to stream when they're home, because it's like, they'll be listening in and stuff, and I can't really, like, the thing is with voiceovers, and if I do it when somebody's home, I can just stop it and then wait until they go downstairs again and then restart my voiceover, if that makes sense. But with a stream, I can't really stop, so I don't really know what to do. Maybe if they find out about my channel one day, then I might start it, because it's not going to be much of a big deal by then. Or I could maybe start streaming, because, you know, I could maybe just be quiet for a few seconds until they go downstairs, or I can maybe actually tell them, you know what, I could have actually just told them that I'm streaming, so don't come upstairs or something, because what actually happens is sometimes, I remember it was my toddler stuff pack review video I was doing, because I got early access for that, but the actual codes got sent through at like 5 a.m, and then the embargo lifted at 3 p.m, so you know, I didn't really have that much time to get everything done, and it was like 2 p.m, and I was trying to get my voiceover done for the review, and my mum was busy doing something in the computer, like the study room, doing some work or something. So, I didn't know what to do, because she wouldn't go downstairs. I was like, I've got a really, really important video to do. You need to go downstairs. And she wouldn't have it. So, I closed every single door from that room to mine. I got my little sister to guard the door. That sounds so stupid. Not really guard the door, but she was just kind of listening out to make sure nobody came in my room. Because, like I said, she's the only person who knows, and she's, you know, very familiar with YouTube culture and everything, and she understands. So, yeah, I'm glad that she's here to make sure nobody embarrasses while I'm recording. Anyway, so, yeah, I'm going to try and see what I can do, because it's currently 12 p.m. that I'm recording this voiceover on, and it's around this time of day that's the only chance I am home alone. So, you know, if I'm going to be doing streams, I feel like a good time to do it is around like 6 p.m. my time, which is, well, actually the times have just changed today, actually, because it's the 29th of October, the clocks went back an hour. So it's kind of like a normal time stream would be around 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Around that sort of time is when it works out for most people, which is like 5 p.m. my time, so that doesn't really work out, because it's not around that time that I get a chance to be home alone. So I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to really think things through, because I actually, you know, I do really want to do streams in addition to videos, but, you know, and I know some people are kind of switching over to Twitch streams completely. I don't really want to do that, because, you know, I feel like Twitch streams are something that you can't always watch if you don't have the free time to sit there and watch the full thing. But with YouTube videos, like I mentioned earlier, you can watch a little bit, and if you have to go ahead and do something, you can pause it and come back. So I feel like Twitch, for me, at least, should be something I do in addition to YouTube videos in my normal schedule. So, you know, and I don't think streams is going to be something I'm going to be doing on an actual schedule, because, like I said, you know, with parents being home, it's really hard to do that. I'm just going to have to figure things out. Let me know if you have any thoughts about that and what I should do. And yeah, so we're just working on one of these final bedrooms here. This is the second last one. As you can see, each of the bedrooms have kind of got their own theme in terms of a colour scheme. And I have been using purple a lot, as you can see in that other bedroom. I don't know what it is, but I have been using neutral colours quite a bit recently. And I have been trying to switch things up using more, you know, just different colours, colourful ones as well. And purple's always been one I've been going to. I don't know why, it's kind of just something very different, I think. And that's probably why I've been using it. But now I feel like I'm using it all the time. So oh my god, anyway. So we're pretty much finished with the build here. You may have noticed, but I did do a few jump cuts earlier on in the video when I was doing the landscaping, because that kind of gets a little bit boring. And also when I was going through putting all the doors in, doing the floor plan, choosing the wall coverings. I normally do that off screen as well, because once I actually go in to decorate the room, you're going to see what wall covering and what flooring I use. So there's no really point of me recording the bit where I'm trying to figure out what I'm going to do. I mean, sometimes maybe helpful in terms of floor plans, which I do leave in sometimes, but sometimes it does a little bit take me too long and it's like really boring to watch. So yeah, anyway, so after we finish this, we've got one more bathroom to do, then we're pretty much finished with the video. So I really hope you enjoyed this speed build. If you did, please make sure you let me know about what you thought of it in the comments section down below. Make sure you let me know what you want to see next in terms of another speed build, or any videos in general, maybe cats and dogs, because that should be going up pretty soon. Maybe it's already out by the time you see this, I'm not really 100% sure. And yes, so make sure you leave a like, comment, share and subscribe if you haven't. Head over to the gallery to download this for yourself. My origin ID is real, ThomasTV1, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.